In today's video, I'm going to be showing you a simple, cheap, no-brainer mod that you can do on your existing Arcade1Up modded pinball projects. Now, this is going to be specific to the DMD screen itself, because we're going to uncover some hidden potential that lays behind the plexiglass overlay. Now, this is thanks to community members like yourself that go out there and come up with new, innovative ways to improve these machines, whether it be the Arcade1Up pinball machines, the At Games machines, you name it. The community is always striving and driving to make these machines better for users like me and you. And speaking of striving and driving to make the world a better place, I've got to give a special shout out to today's video sponsor, Skillshare, who does amazing work in the YouTube content creator space and allows me to make videos like this for you. Shout out to Skillshare for sponsoring this video and all the work they do helping creators on this platform. Haven't heard of Skillshare? Well, let me educate you. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creators. You can explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and get lost in creativity. It's curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads and they're always rolling out new classes for you to discover, so you can stay focused and follow along with ease. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription, and I just recently finished watching YouTube Success Script, Shoot, and Edit with MKBHD, and it's always been fascinating to me personally to see the creative process of others, and this class provides wonderful insight as to how you can create the most compelling content with whatever tools you have around you. No fancy or expensive equipment required. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of the premium membership so you can explore your creativity. So if you're looking to enhance your creativity, make sure you take advantage of this free trial deal. So once again, this really only applies to people that have modded their Arcade1Up pinball machines. Technically, you could do this mod to a stock Arcade1Up pinball machine, but you're really not going to get any kind of advantages out of it because the fixed aspect ratio of that scoreboard on the DMD screen, thanks to the PCB settings, are not really going to allow you to stretch your score and utilize the extra space that we're going to gain on this DMD. So specifically what we're talking about today is this 3D printed bezel that I found on the Thingiverse thanks to a user named Mr. Hector. I don't know Mr. Hector personally, but thumbs up, man. This is a great idea, great concept, and I love everything about it. But very easy, cheap, simple solution to a problem that was kind of vexing to me. I would put images on that secondary scoreboard and they would just look awful for the most part. I could resize them, yeah, sure, but in their native aspect ratio and things like that, I could tell that the top and the bottom was being cropped off. Once you remove the plexiglass overlay for that scoreboard after you take off the speaker grills and everything like that, you'll see that there's actually a bigger screen behind that plexiglass overlay. So Arcade1Up has obviously done that too, since their stock machines have that fixed aspect ratio to make it look less noticeable that you've got all this dead space on the top and the bottom. However, if you've modded your pinball machine and you've got a bigger score stretched out now, you want to take advantage of this full-on screen size. So this is going to allow you to do that. So what I would suggest you do is completely remove the plexiglass altogether and you simply mount this in the space in the middle. The mounting holes line up perfectly with the stock mounting holes and this covers up the, you know, the notches and everything of the screen being embedded in the board. However, you can also do it differently. You could cut out the middle section of your plexiglass and save the sides, put your speaker grills back on, and then put this over the middle as well. Either way, great idea, great solution. I'll put the Thingiverse link down in the video description box below so you can find it, download it, say thanks to Mr. Hector, because this is obviously, again, a no-brainer solution for something that was personally annoying to me, and I'm sure if you're modding your pinball machine, you definitely want to bring out the best in it. So definitely check it out. Can't recommend it enough. Like I said, stupid simple, stupid easy. Anybody can do it with a 3D printer. If you don't own a 3D printer, there's companies and places out there that'll print these for you. Shouldn't cost you hardly anything at all. It's thick enough that it's not going to break, but it's also thin enough that you don't have to spend 6 hours waiting for it to print either.
Sacrifices must be made. to reach your wishes.
Definitely check it out. And once again, thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. If you enjoyed the content, make sure you hit that like button, share this video with your friend if you found the information helpful. And as always, thanks for watching, guys. It really means a lot.